Welcome to the short video on how to determine the number of Fluke 3563 analysis vibration sensors that are needed. To survey the machines for each implementation phase, use the deployment planning guide and follow the five steps. Step number one, survey the machine space where you plan to deploy the vibration sensors and select the assets to monitor. Collect the basic information about your assets and complete the first section of the worksheet. Step two from the deployment planning guide, use the machine images to help guide you. Determine how many test points are required for each monitored machine for sensor installation. Look at your machine and identify the shaft, the bearings, power transfer, and driven component. We recommend one sensor per bearing, but this may not be needed for small machines. Vibration transmits about 36 inches or 1 meter before it's lost through the machine. There is no need to measure every bearing on small machines. Rule of thumb is at least one sensor per shaft, one for the motor, one for the pump. Next, determine the type and number of adapter plates. Each sensor needs an adapter plate to securely mount the sensor to the metal surface of the machine. The two choices are screw mount and epoxy mount. If you cannot drill into your machine, then use the epoxy mounts. Finally, fill in sections 2 and 3 of the worksheet with the number of sensors and adapter plates. Step 3 from the deployment planning guide. Determine the number of gateways needed in each space. Sometimes a simple hand-drawn map will help you. The gateway collects measurement data from the sensors and then transfers the data to the Live Asset Portal. A single gateway communicates with up to 20 sensors. The gateway uses a low-energy wireless protocol to communicate with the sensor up to 100 meters line of sight. There is no easy way to know the true distance in the real world with metal, concrete, walls, etc. that may be in your space. Adjustments can be made later during the actual installation, especially if you have a couple of extra sensors and one spare gateway. Step 4 from the deployment planning guide. Ensure availability of network connectivity in the installation location via either Wi-Fi or Ethernet. And finally, step 5 is to place your order using numbers from the worksheet. Keep the worksheet, your notes, and your hand-drawn map to use as a reference during the installation. Be sure to watch the other short videos on when to use reliability and how to use the 3563 and 3562 sensors.